The surface was 1,324 kilometers squared. In the 1930s, the Soviet government decided to drain the lake for no real reason, just used the water for irrigation. And the majority of the water went to Azerbaijan actually for irrigation. And the water level dropped by 20 meters. So before the 1930s, all this area was underwater. This was not a peninsula, it was the island of Fiksiba. So they drained the lake, and then in the 40s they realized that they shouldn't drain an entire lake. So in the 60s they started building a tunnel to raise the water level. 47 kilometers long tunnel from the south. Inside. During the Soviet times, these were kept in the cupola of the church because they were afraid if they took them down, they would use this as construction material. And these are holy stones for us. So only after 1991, they brought it down for people to see the different designs, although most of them are destroyed and half preserved. There was a praying cell for the monks so they could get isolated and meditate in there. And it's partly painted, partly carved, and has a lot of Iranian influence, Persian influence on it. Even the monks on the bottom look like Persians, not Armenians. It's logical, the painters who were actually Armenian, but the people they saw were Persian, so they just painted them according to Persian style. And it's also the school and the influence, and sometimes they had to go to compromise and just do it according to the Persian or any Islam. Okay, let's go. So the Haj Kar or cross stone in Armenia, it has been carved and is still being carved all over the world where Armenians live, and also in Armenia, of course. The main use of these stones were tombstones. But they were also used for different reasons to mark different events like victories during the war, coronation of a king, construction of a human bridge or hospital or a fortress, and certain cross stones dedicated to certain saints supposedly had certain powers. If the cross stone was carved in honor of the Holy Virgin, they supposedly gave fertility to women. If the cross stone was dedicated to Saint Gregory, it was to give bravery to soldiers, and so on. And besides all those purposes, these were also a form of art. That's why we say there are not the two cross stones which are alike in the whole country, because it was the honor and principle of every artist to be unique and not copy someone. Summer house of the Armenian poets and writers during the Soviet times. So all those poets and writers who wrote good things about the Soviet government were sent here for vacation. All those who wrote bad things were sent to Siberia for a nice lifetime vacation. And there were more people going over there than coming here. Now they're abandoned. This one is sometimes being used as a restaurant. But thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, this is the pagan temple of Garni. It was built in 77 AD by our king Artad II. He went to visit the Roman Emperor Nero, and there he got inspired by the Hellenic architecture and came back and ordered the construction of the temple. So this was not built by the Romans themselves. It was built by our king. And we don't have anything built by the Romans. Whatever we used to have pagan was...
This was the altar, the sacrifice table. Behind the sacrifice table, they had a statue of Mitra in the form of a bull. This hall was filled with water and had a marble stone inside. It was not covered up, the covering is visible. And there is a hole up there, so when the sun was at its highest point, the sun rays would fall on the marble and reflected on the statue. And the hot water part, warm water part, and cold water part at the end. And it was a steam bath. So this was very hot, a bit less hot than cold. And the whole area was that like that rebuilt part. So it has this column, the water was flowing through, and there was an area for people to stand. And at the back there is a mosaic, so if you come closer. This was the changing room, and the whole floor was covered with a mosaic made out of 15 natural stones, and they got the stones from the river basin down there. In the center it had the goddess of the sea, surrounded by mermaids and fish, and a Greek inscription saying, taking nothing, we labored, and no one knows.
We hide in the whole building, which is a very nice hide. That's why we call it the Symphony of the Stone. And this is just a simple version of it. All over the valley it's like this. And the part over there is very spectacular. It's very amazing how the columns have their shape. And that's the river, the Azad River. And you must be...